All right, so once you get your machine cleaned off real good, then what you want to do is take your sew machine oil and your just your little squeeze bottle, and we're just gonna rock this wheel back and forth, and you can see where all the moving parts are, and you just want to go and, you know, oil these, you know, pretty good. You don't want to drench it in oil because then it's gonna get all over your floor, but, you know, give it some good amount. And you can see here, you know, wherever there's a little, they have these little sponges that hold, that soak up oil, and what that does is it helps keep everything lubricated while the machine is operating. We're not going to oil this because we're going to put grease on that there, so you can skip that. But you can see all up in here. And also rocking it back and forth helps work the oil inside these moving parts. Alright, so that's pretty good right there. Next thing we're going to do is we're just going to put some grease in here. What you don't want to do is put too much, otherwise it'll spin and get all around inside your machine and make a mess. But just dip your finger in here, and all I'm going to do is just hold it on these gears and spin it while it just picks it up off my finger. And you kind of want to work it in so that it gets inside all the gears. And you can see while we're doing that, it's also getting it on this bottom one here too for you. So, you know, use your best judgment and put a good amount on there, but don't overdo it. Alright, so I'm feeling pretty good about that. I can already feel the machine's actually moving quite a bit smoother. So now that we're done with the bottom here, we're gonna flip it back up, and then we can clean the top of the machine. The reason we didn't do that before is because when we're blowing all this stuff out, what can happen is it gets the top all dirty. So let's go ahead and flip this back up, and we'll clean the outside of the machine. All right, now we can go ahead and oil the rest of the machine on top here. It's a good idea to look in your manual. They're going to tell you all the different oil spots that you need to oil on your machine. It's kind of nice on this machine, for all the oil spots on the outside, they have it marked with red paint here. So make sure you hit all those oil spots. But also you want to hit all the moving, parts inside this machine. It's going to be kind of hard for me to show you this. My head's going to be in the way, so I'm just going to kind of do the best I can. But make sure you look in your manual, and it will show you all the spots you need to hit. Make sure, again, if there's any little sponges or ropes in there, you want to try and get those pretty saturated. Like there's a little sponge rope right here that soaks up oil and helps get inside this moving part here. Some of the parts have little holes on top that help get oil inside, so make sure you just get all those real good. And then hit all the little oil spots on the outside of your machine. What you don't want to do is really overdo it, because then what's going to happen is it's going to make a big mess, and it can, you know, get your fabric dirty when you're sewing it. So it's a good idea just to, you know, one or two drops of oil and everything's pretty good. This machine has this little reservoir here that, you know, you don't want to fill it all the way up, but just get enough in there, you know, for it to keep the rope that's inside of it saturated. And what that does is that it sucks the oil slowly through the string and it feeds it into parts that are inside the machine here. So it's important to keep that oiled. Got some spots over here. All right, so once we're done oiling that, what we can do is put all of these pieces back on. So we're gonna start with putting the feed dog back on. And one thing you really wanna make sure is that you put this back on the right way, because this feed dog actually has this little tab here on the bobbin case that goes in here. There's a little notch right there. And what that does is holds it in place. You can see how I can move this back and forth right now, and that's gonna cause a big problem if you have it out of alignment when you put this back together and it doesn't, and you go and try and sew. So be aware of that. And then you can just put the screws back in the same way we took them out. Remember, like I said, don't do them too tight. Just snug. And you always wanna, whenever you're putting really anything back together, you always wanna start them by hand first. Don't just go in there with a screwdriver and put it straight in, because you can cross thread things and that's a nightmare to fix. So just be careful with that. And these screws on this plate here, they're tapered, so it lines this up for you by itself. And we can just put this back in here. And, you know, just snug it up. It doesn't need to be crazy tight. Make sure you go in the right direction too, that always helps. All right, so that's done. Now we can put these plates back on. We can put this plate back on. All right, and then the last step you want to do is, after you just cleaned your sewing machine and blew all this garbage all over the place, you want to clean your table off, but then you also want to clean the outside of your machine off. I mean, you can see, you know, there's a little dust that gets stuck on the outside and sometimes under here. And the reason you want to keep all that clean is, say you're feeding some fabric through and it, maybe it's white or something and it rubs up on the machine, you know, then you get your fabric dirty, kind of like your paper towel gets dirty, and you don't want that. So we'll just go and wipe this down. You'll do a good job wiping it all down. Get it real clean. And this is also where, say if you see where there's any glue spots that are stuck on your machine, that's where you'd want to get your glue remover and put some glue remover on your paper towel and clean the glue off. There's not any glue spots on here because I keep it pretty clean. So just wipe down the table. We blew a bunch of junk all over it when we were cleaning it out. All right, guys, now that your sewing machine's all clean again, you can go ahead and start sewing your next project. It's really important to remember to do this on a regular basis. You know, you wanna oil your sewing machine. If you're gonna be using it every day, you wanna oil it every other day would be pretty good practice to be in. And then you wanna clean it after every big job, especially when you're working with canvas. Like I said, for some reason, canvas really likes to, it makes a dust and it really likes to get inside your machine. And so make sure there's no threads and stuff in there. And if you keep on this, it's really gonna save you a lot of time and headache, and it's gonna make your equipment last a lot longer. So don't forget to do it. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. Tell me some other stuff you guys would like to see. Check out my website, theluckyneedle.com. You can sign up there and get access to these videos before I release them on YouTube. So I'll see you guys soon. Have a great day.